7874 joueurs ont déboursé 10 000 dollars pour participer au plus beau tournoi du monde. 10 jours plus tard, ils ne sont plus que 3 et le chip leader s'appelle Tony Miles. C'est ici qu'il réside, à Cindy Way, Las Vegas, ce joueur originaire de Floride, 32 ans, coaché par Pierre Calamusa. Et oui, le Camoulox, mais c'est bien le pro du team Winamax qui lui donne des conseils durant toute la finale. Et c'est grâce à lui que nous allons pouvoir pénétrer dans son intimité. Nous allons découvrir comment se passe ce coaching et puis nous allons l'accompagner durant toute sa finale, durant la quête vers les 8,8 millions de dollars et le titre de champion du monde.
So, maybe we can take what we, like we did every day. We can take, so we draw the table. Okay. And we will define the ranges for all the spots. So, okay, so let's start. So,
Donc Pierre, cette histoire nous paraît complètement improbable. Explique-nous comment tu es le coach du chip leader à 3 joueurs restants sur le main event.
Bah, c'est une histoire complètement folle. Je pense qu'il y a une part de probablement de destin ou beaucoup de chance aussi. C'était un matin, je me suis réveillé et il y avait Steph qui nous avait mis un message sur notre chat WhatsApp du Team Pro Winamax en disant qu'il y avait beaucoup d'overlay sur un 600 dollars du Planet Hollywood. Il faut savoir que le Planet Hollywood, c'est les pires conditions de jeu du point com, quoi. C'est vraiment, les croupiers savent rien faire, t'es descended, t'as de la musique à fond, bon, c'est horrible. Mais bon, comme il y avait de l'overlay, j'y suis allé, je suis tombé à la droite justement de Tony. Enfin, Tony était à ma droite plutôt. On a joué toute la journée ensemble et j'avais été vraiment impressionné par déjà par la qualité de son jeu et aussi surtout par sa capacité de concentration. C'était vraiment très, très prenant ça chez lui, qu'il était vraiment à 100% sur chaque coup. Et après, donc on s'est changé nos Facebook, on est devenus potes, on a commencé à sortir ensemble, à faire des restos, il est venu à la villa du team, voilà, donc j'ai appris à le connaître et c'était un mec formidable et du coup, voilà, c'est comme ça que je suis devenu un peu son coach, quoi.
On sent qu'il y a une vraie amitié qui s'est créée entre vous, d'où ça vient? Vous avez des parcours similaires?
Ouais, je me suis beaucoup identifié à lui, parce que c'est un mec qui a eu à lutter contre ses démons, de manière beaucoup plus intense que moi encore. Il a eu beaucoup de problèmes de drogue, il a eu beaucoup de problèmes d'addiction à l'alcool par exemple, et il a réussi à s'en sortir, il a été broke de nombreuses fois, un parcours qui peut être un peu similaire au mien on va dire, et aujourd'hui il est devenu la meilleure version de lui-même en fait, si tu veux, c'est-à-dire qu'il s'est sorti de tout ça et par sa force de caractère, par sa volonté, il est devenu ultra rigoureux, il a perdu du poids, il est ultra stock, et puis c'est devenu un excellent joueur de poker et aujourd'hui voilà, il y a une bonne étoile qui est au-dessus de lui et qui lui amène ce run, donc c'est incroyable.
Alors en ce 14 juillet, ils ne sont plus que 3 sur le main event, Tony est large chip leader. Comment se passe le coaching quand on a en plus de tels paliers, 3 millions de dollars assurés, 8,8 millions de dollars à la gagne?
Bah bien sûr, l'ICM, ça a été notre première considération. Comme c'est un joueur de cash game, il n'avait pas trop de compréhension de l'ICM. Donc ça a été la première chose que j'ai essayé de lui expliquer. Et c'est un joueur qui est tellement intelligent qu'en fait, l'ICM, c'est assez intuitif. Donc du coup, il a tout de suite compris. On a été short tout le long. On a été short toutes les demi-finales. On a été short de 10 left jusqu'à 6 left. Et ensuite, il y a eu ce gros flip contre Jokada qui nous a permis de passer big stack. Et là, il a tout de suite repris ses réflexes de joueur de cash game à être très agressif, etc. Donc, je pense que c'était un bon mix. Voilà, on a eu un peu de chance aussi. On a passé les bons flips au bon moment. En fait, quoique, ouais, on a passé un énorme flip contre Kada. Voilà, donc c'était principalement lui faire comprendre l'ICM. Et après, il a de tellement bons instincts que finalement, c'est juste l'accompagner, lui dire un petit peu comment construire ses ranges, quel range 3 bet, quel range 4 bet, etc. Et puis après, son intelligence fait le reste, quoi.
Tu fais que dire « on » et j'ai l'impression que tu vis ce tournoi encore plus que si tu étais en train de le jouer. Raconte-nous un peu les vibrations.
Bah ouais, c'est une histoire d'équipe, quoi. Bien sûr, c'est lui qui fait 95% du travail. Comme ça fait trois joueurs qu'on travaille ensemble, forcément. Et puis comme je suis dans son rail, je mange avec sa famille. Forcément, tu deviens comme une grande famille, quoi. Tu te sens inclus. Donc ouais, ce sera comme quand tu parles de ton équipe de foot, tu dis « on », hein, c'est normal.
You good?
Hi, Pierre. How are you, sweetie?
Good.
Good.
I'm so happy that you got a new iPhone.
Yeah, man. You got a new iPhone? Nice, nice. How you doing?
Good, sweetie.
How much blinds do you have? Like 130, something like that?
16. We're at 1.6 and we're at 240. Oh, I'm blowing up right now.
That year is going to be 17 blinds. This is a framework, okay?
Just not the Jack ten suited, not the Queen ten suited, not the King ten suited.
Hats and pairs.
Yes, sixes. And our calling range will be top 11%, I think.
5-5 plus, it's gonna be easier. Ace 10 off plus. Ace 9 suited plus.
And King Queen.
King Queen off, right?
Yes, that's great. So when you're sleeping, try to visualize this, it's very important. Like,
is my calling range for dyers
like
reshoves or just open
shoves? Reshoves, is your button open?
Yes. What I want you to do is that you need really to be precise on the, just on the calling ranges. And for the shoving range for bind, you don't need to be very precise, just know, have a general idea of what you shove. Okay? To not make a big mistake. Okay? If you make a small mistake of shoving too wide or a small mistake of folding too much, it's not a problem. It's gonna be 0.1 EVBB, so you will lose no money at all, okay? Just don't make any mistakes, like folding your hands that you absolutely shouldn't fold, or shoving hands that you absolutely shouldn't fold, shove. That's it.
Yeah,
that's
not can you see yourself shove?
What's wrong?
Yeah. You will have to shove some hands like 10-5 solid at one time.
Fives plus, ace 10 off, queen jack suited plus.
And it would be tighter than some shove here.
Yes,
I agree. A lot tighter.
Yeah, I agree. What do we think about the strategy when Sin opens button?
Yeah, we should play very tight. We open very tight.
Yeah. Are we...
We're gonna 3-bet some ace 2 straight 5 suited and a value.
So we 3-bet 10-10 plus.
Remember that the less blinds that you will have, every time he like chip down, you call a bit wider. Every time he chips up, you call less, because the risk reward would be worse.
Sin opens, we are small blind.
Sin opens on our small blind, okay?
No, yes, on our small blind,
okay.
And dyer is a big blind.
Okay.
We will have so flatting range and three betting range.
Okay.
The three bets range will be as you know, like very polar.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be 10-10, jack-jack, queen-queen, king-king, aces. And we will mix
some slow play with aces and kings.
Yes, exactly. We'll submit ace king as well, not ace queen.
We'll flat ace queen.
Yes, we'll flat ace queen.
We'll 3-bet ace king.
Yes. Clear, it's very clear that we can go broke with ace king preflop.
We can,
of course.
We can, okay.
Depends. If you think that you have the good momentum that you will fold a lot, you can go to ace deuce to ace line suited, I don't care. The only problem is that Sin will be opening very tight. Remember this. So we don't want to go too much, too nuts with the three betting light. When Sin opens, he thinks you will play back at him on the small blind, he thinks Dyer will shove a lot. So he won't open crap like yesterday.
If Sin opens, we're calling fives through nines.
Yes.
And like ace 10 off.
Yeah, ace 10 off could
okay.
Be good. Ace queen.
Ace queen.
King queen.
3-bet ace king. Then we're also 3-bet.
Queen jack suited, jack 10 suited, you can flat.
Tens plus. Right, that's what we said. Flatting fives through nines and three betting tens plus.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
You got it.
I mean, I'm working on it.
I'm gonna send you these charts to.
I think the first thing you should do is visualize your opening range of the button.
Okay. So.
And it's good because it's on the screenshot and it's
okay.
Very clear.
All right. Thank you for coming.
No.
Appreciate it.
It's not hard. I'm not gonna leave you not today.
What?
I'm not gonna not show up today. I mean, it's the most important one.
Yeah, that's the most important.
Man, you can be the world running champion.
Well, I think today is the most critical because I probably have the least experience playing shorthanded, three-handed.
That's
heads
why
up.
You need to have
to
a
study.
Good guideline, so you do not make huge mistakes.
Right.
Take your time. Even if it's a clear shove, slow down. Make sure that you don't make any big mistake. You will be world champion if you don't make any big mistake.
Trust you. Give me a test. Yeah, ask me. Fives plus,
yeah.
Ace 10 off plus, ace five suited plus.
Fives and nines, yeah.
Queen jack suited.
Yeah.
D'ailleurs, open shove, you call 5-5 plus.
Yeah, wait, let me do it. 5-5 plus. Ace 10 off plus. Instead of laying down, I'm going to meditate for 10 minutes.
Perfect.
And then I'll come back in and we'll get back to work. Okay? Sound good?
Yeah.
Let's fucking go.
You were thinking about destiny, but you had a lot of good spots.
I'm running really pure.
If you want to win the 8,000 player tournaments, you need to play good and run good.
Yeah.
So just play good. We'll see about the run.
I played like 10, 15 tournaments out here last year. I only made one day two.
Yes.
And then like all of like the past year, I've just like run really bad in tournaments. And this is like the other side of the variance.
This is the extreme of
yeah.
the other side of the variance.
For your whole life, you run above you.
Yeah.
It's good, huh?
Yeah, because I think I ran pretty far below EV in like the pits and stuff.
What is a pit?
Gambling.
Oh,
like
yes.
baccarat.
Me too, you know?
Okay guys, I think yeah, my grill's hot out there. It's a beautiful story for us. I said it went from a sort of a, you know, the Wizard of Oz story?
What?
Wizard of Oz?
No.
Where Dorothy goes to the Emerald City. In a dream, she gets knocked out in a tornado. She gets knocked out and she goes to the Emerald City and she picks up all these characters along the way.
Okay,
so
no,
she,
I don't know.
You don't know this story?
No, I don't know the story. Okay.
She said, all I want to do is go home to Kansas. I just want to go home to Kansas. And they said, well, you'll have to talk to the great magician, you know. And so they finally get her in to see him. And he says, well, I can't help you. And so then the good witch comes to her and she said, look at your shoes. She said, you're wearing your red sparkly shoes. She said, you've had the power all along to go home. All you needed to do was click your heels and it'll send you right home. So she clicked her heels and she went back home to Kansas and everything was great and happy. And I said, that's Tony's story, because all he ever needed to do was click his heels, believe in himself, and he could do anything.
It's a great story, yeah. So every day I say, click your heels, and believe in yourself.
Nice.
And now he did. He clicked his heels, so we got to click them one more time, though.
I don't know anything about poker. Nothing.
You're just Jerry.
When I see them make the money and gotcha. But I told Tony, this is funny, you probably like this. I told Tony, I said, when I get back, you have to hire me a teacher because I want to understand.
He's a teacher.
He can't teach.
He can't.
No, too impatient. But how much so I can understand when I see the cars, I'll know what's happening. Because right now I can't even look. I put my head down and then I see him rake the money in. I'm like, yay!
So now we can only talk about the heads up strategy.
Wait, can you guys test me on the ranges one more time?
Yeah, sure.
Once again?
This is just a loose thing and it's up to me and I have to feel it myself.
You need to have an idea, a general idea.
Uh-huh.
If you you make small mistakes, it's not a big deal. Can we do the calling range for the big blind if they open shove? Very important.
Yes.
So you do it. It's easy. Scene opens from the button while the small blind. How do we construct build our 3-bet and calling range?
We want to use hands that have good equity to call against Dyer's reshuffle.
Yeah. So what are those?
We're going to use like ace 9 suited, ace 10 off plus. We're going to call ace queen off. We're going to 3-bet ace king. And we're going to 3-bet 10s plus and flat with 5s through 9s.
Yes, exactly. I don't know what to say about the heads up. It's probably going to be like 100 big blind zip, most likely.
Somewhere between 70 and 100, yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of you understanding what you need to do. Because it's heads up is a game that is very complicated, and we don't know what the stack size will be.
Right. So
we can give you general strategy,
After this will be up to you. What I recommend is that, so we said we open like 80?
Yeah.
We will screenshot you what 80% is. It's a lot of bad hands.
Yep.
It's not because you raise pre-flop that you see bets. You should check back a lot of, like, for example, you raise some, you know, king five, become ace, king, deuce. That's very good candidate check back. This theory we cannot teach you in 1 hour.
Yeah.
Bonjour tout le monde.
This is Tony Miles.
This is Tony Miles.
Et je vais être champion du monde.
Oh my gosh, come on, that's complicated. I can't say
that. Et je vais être champion du monde.
Come on, dude, I can't do that. Just take the you mean
yes.
Tony Miles.
Yes.
He's gonna be a millionaire.
Yes.
Easy.
Get out of here.
Then we make 1 week of party and you're broke again. Like I do all the time.
Jen, make sure I don't hang out with Pierre when we win, okay? I'm gonna be broke.
Let's
do it. Tony. Here, sit down, buddy.
Can I have some? Yeah, absolutely.
You
can get your glass full
water.
Please.
Yes.
Please.
You have to pray with me,
though. It's nothing fancy.
Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, Lord, we just ask that you keep our minds sharp, our tongues quiet and soft-spoken, and our hearts full of love. Father, send us the spirits of all the close ones that we've lost. Be with us. Allow us to be humble, graceful winners and graceful losers.
Yes,
Father, we ask that you just bless us and let your light shine through us here on earth. In your name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Seat.
I remember that one night we went to the club and you wanted to get a table. I'm like, dude, I don't have that much money. You're like, it's fine, I have plenty.
Yeah.
You bought the table.
And so that, you know, when I've been down a lot, I've been broke a lot. And your real friends are here when you're broke.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like, okay, hey buddy, you need money. Take, I have some now, and if one day you have a problem, then you have some, you know what I mean? The money is here to provide the joy and
happiness,
to give you good experiences, to travel, to meet some new people. The money for itself, it's crap, it's nothing, it's paper, it's...
Mm-hmm. I think a lot of Americans don't think that way. We're very greedy in this country.
Yeah, a lot of people, you are broke, you are nobody.
Exactly.
Like, how much winning do you have? So that's how we judge people?
Mm-hmm.
By how much hand and mouth they have?
Mm-hmm.
What is this?
Yeah, I'm going to get dressed.
Who will be there when you have nothing left?
Yeah.
She's a mom for everyone.
Right.
She's a mom for me as well.
Yeah, for you as well. Yeah. This is the routine we've had all week. This is what's worked so far. This is what we keep doing.
Mm-hmm.
We'll stick to it.
You always need good routines to be performant.
The meditations helped me so much because before I was just like really impatient and impulsive. I just wanted to go.
Yeah.
I need to do this, do that. And now I like slow down and breathe. I can actually think about, and then I can structure like my day efficiently.
But it's funny because all the advice that I give you,
mm-hmm.
it's the advice that my coach give me.
Right.
But I know how hard it is to apply it. I know, just like you say, oh yeah, you have to be calm. Okay, you have to project in the future and see all different scenarios. So that just like it's so easy.
Yeah.
And I can do it myself because me, I had a lot of depression that I just threw away because I was impatient. And because once again, I was impatient. Like in Prague, I had this hand where it was 15 left. I had 30 big blinds and I 4 bet of king 10. And I busted. And
it wasn't
I think.
A good spot.
Maybe it was, but I think it was in general strategy that I had, I didn't stick to it.
Mm-hmm.
My general strategy was playing tight because I went in the middle of the pack
mm-hmm.
and see what happened. And I didn't stick to it for once again.
Mm-hmm.
You stick to the strategy all the time.
I trust you, so it's easy to stick to the strategy because I know that you know what you're doing.
Because you did the job. I mean, when you had to play aggro, we didn't talk too much about it. I just said, okay, play aggro, put on pressure. But you did 12.
So I'm not a complete fish. There's a lot of better players than me out there. But I would like to be one of the best in the world one day.
A lot of work. A lot of dedication.
30 minutes, guys.
The situation can change, but I can't change as a person. That's the most important part.
You changed before.
Yeah.
That's what I thought to me. It's just like you became the better version of yourself, the best version you can be.
Right.
That's normally the work of a lifetime, to be the best you can be.
Yeah. Came to believe that a power greater than myself was working with me, for me, and helping me. And this is evidence.
Did you believe in God your life?
Or
it was just...
I did, but it was... There were points where I was skeptical, and I just didn't have proof. And then it was more like when I was like down and I was like broke or addicted to drugs, I would be like, oh God, God, please help me, please help me. But that's not the way God works.
Yeah. And when you were like having a lot of money and partying, you were like,
who needs God? Like, I thought I was God, not was God, but I thought I didn't need God.
Yeah.
Now I just understand that I need God and that God is the one responsible for all these things, and he makes it very clear. Like, there's so much evidence that it's him and not me.
So whatever you do, you are never responsible, no? You can say everything is destiny.
I had an experience a few weeks ago where I felt like God spoke to me, and he told me that I was gonna have to be a warrior for him. And I accepted, and this has been the result so far. I can't chalk it up to good luck. I mean,
yeah, of course.
Just everything. Like, I've become the best version of myself, and it happened after that. You know, I didn't just say like, oh, I want to be kinder. I want to be nice. I want to be well mannered. I want to be more thoughtful. I want to be more precise. Like, this experience happened, and then it just became me.
Yeah, it's perfect.
My heart was like more compassionate for people, and I thought about myself less and other people way more.
Yeah, it's good.
I don't know if that's possible. Just like
the simple idea of God, whether it exists or not, if it leads people to be better persons,
then it's good.
Then, so be it. Anyway,
I'm not telling you what to believe, I'm just telling you what I believe.
Yes, of course. And you know who can say but God exists or good doesn't believe.
Well, that's my belief.
That's bad.
Let's go day 10.
Let's go.
Wait for it.
This one.
Yes. Perfect.
Alright, let's find this camera quickly. Oh, I mean, that's not it. I already have
the back off. Okay.
I think today I'll wear no sweatshirt.
What?
Today I'll wear no sweatshirt.
No sweatshirt?
No sweatshirt. Just seriously?
Yes.
You have the keys, Jen?
Yes.
Let's go. What time is it?
Time to win the main event.
What time is it actually?
4:50. Time to win the main event. All right, Mama Bear. All
right, teach me poker, I'll teach you to drive.
My loves. Love you. I need one more hug.
Let him go. Let's go.
Love you.
All right, love you. Thank you.
Love you, love you, love you, love you, love you. Love you.
Don't worry. He's gonna be the happiest day of his life.
I know, that's why I'm crying happy tears.
Listening now,
Until they hear.